I speak to you now not only as your magistrate, but as your friend. I caution you to exercise discretion today. This trial is being held in accordance with the legal code of the Republic, and the judgment I render will be based on truth and justice. Any person who attempts to interfere with the due course of justice will be arrested and prosecuted. The government of the Republic will be heard.
I hope Your Honor will forgive this intrusion. My name is Houston. I'm attorney for the defendants.
Senor Bowie, is this true?
It's all right with me.
You may proceed, Colonel Koss.
The Republic of Mexico formally charges the accused persons, named James Bowie and Pablo Dominguez, with conspiring to make a revolution. To put her more plainly, Your Honor, high treason against her country.
These are grave charges, Colonel Koss.
They are indeed. Although I am sure Senor Bowie's attorney will appeal the case to a higher court, the punishment will be exacted just the same. And this punishment, may I remind you, is death.
The Colonel need not refresh the court's knowledge of the law. You may present your evidence.
Very well. On the night of December the 12th, in the year of our Lord, 1830...
If it please the court. Your Honor, I respectfully submit that this court is not legally constituted to hear this case.
Senor Houston, the court will decide legality here.
Begging the court's pardon, I again submit that this trial is not legal. I'm not familiar with all the laws of the great Republic of Mexico, but this much I know. A magistrate such as yourself has no jurisdiction in a city that's under martial law.
Senor Houston, the city of San Antonio de Bejar is not under martial law. I am the magistrate of this municipality, elected by the people.
I see. I humbly beg the court's forgiveness for misunderstanding. And I submit, then, that if such is the case, this military officer has no legal authority to make either arrests or accusations.
But when the actions of private citizens imperil the government, her officers have the authority to make arrests.
Your Honor, the Colonel would deprive these gentlemen of the precious freedom the people of Mexico fought and died to secure.
I cannot believe that this court is actually paying attention to such theatrical and completely irrelevant statements from this stranger, a foreigner.
I have paid attention. I am grateful to this stranger for helping to prevent a very grave error. I must ask your forgiveness, my friends. I am an old man, I fear, too accustomed to dealing with relatively small matters here in San Antonio. Perhaps I've grown forgetful of the saber scar I carry from the Battle of Veracruz. It is not a thing one should forget. I recall the days when the soldiers of Spain would invade homes and take people away. Such a thing will not happen here in San Antonio. Not while I am magistrate.
That can be changed very quickly.
Not until the people voted so.
I warn you here and now.
I must remind the Colonel that he's out of order. There is such a thing as contempt of court, and it applies to everyone within these walls.
Does the Colonel have any closing remarks before the court renders a decision?
Only this, Your Honor. I assure you and the people of San Antonio that this will not be forgotten, not by me nor by the General.
The General? Oh, yes. You speak of your brother-in-law, General Santa Anna.
I do. Remember the name, Your Honor.
I shall try. Senor Houston, have you anything more to say?
No, Your Honor. The defense rests.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the people of San Antonio de Bejar in the Republic of Mexico, I hereby declare this case is dismissed.